Hello everyone, in today's video, I'm going to be teaching you how to use one of Wondershare's powerful products called Recover It. But what's it used for? Well, imagine you're using your MacBook Pro to work on an important project, play video games, or even watch a movie, and your MacBook screen goes black, but still running, and you're sure that you've never had issues with it in the past. Then, what might be the problem and the solution? In this video, I'm going to be showing you what could be the reasons why your MacBook screen is black, how to fix it, and how to recover your important files using Recover It. But before we dive deep, please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video. Part 1. Causes of the black screen on MacBook Pro. Now, there are a couple of reasons why your MacBook Pro screen is black, and it either has to do with your software or your hardware. Here are some of the common causes of this issue. Waking from sleep mode. So, your MacBook Pro has been in sleep mode for a while and you try to wake it up, but the screen remains dark even though the MacBook Pro didn't shut down. Bugs or glitches. Specific applications or programs with bugs and glitches could also result in your MacBook screen not turning on. Display issues. If you turn on your MacBook and it seems like it's booting like it used to, but you can't see any display on the screen, then something is probably wrong with your display. Login items. So basically, when your MacBook is booting, there are applications that automatically boot together with it as well, and this could sometimes cause issues like a black MacBook screen. But whatever might be the cause of your MacBook Pro black screen, the good news is there's a solution to the problem. Part 2. How to fix the black screen on your MacBook Pro. Now that we've gotten to the part that you've all been anticipating, I'll waste no time to dive straight into it. Method 1. Reset the T2 chip or the SMC. The steps here are for resetting SMC on the MacBook with a T2 chip. First, turn off your MacBook Pro. Second, press and hold the power button for 10 seconds. Hold on for another few seconds, then press the power button again to turn on your MacBook Pro. And here are the steps to reset SMC on an older version of MacBook without a T2 chip. First, turn off your MacBook Pro. Unplug the power cable. Hold all the SMC reset key combinations for 10 seconds. Shift plus Control plus Option plus Power. Plug in the power cable and turn on your MacBook Pro. Method 2, reset PRAM or NVRAM. PRAM, which is short for Parameter Random Access Memory, and NVRAM, also short for Non-Volatile Random Access Memory, are small amounts in MacBooks, used to store settings and preferences. If some of the files that they carry are corrupted, it can lead to a black or white screen on your MacBook Pro. Here's how you can reset your PRAM or NVRAM when this happens. First, turn off your MacBook Pro. Press the power button to restart it. While it's booting, press and hold Command plus Option plus P plus R. Keep holding these keys until your MacBook Pro restarts. Your PRAM and NVRAM will automatically reset after that. Method 3, boot your MacBook Pro in safe mode. Let's say your MacBook Pro has corrupted disk files or software issues. There are high chances that you're going to face difficulties in booting it, and this might as well lead to a black screen. However, using safe mode to boot your MacBook will not only reduce the chance of a black screen, but it will isolate those corrupted files that are a threat to your MacBook. Here are the steps to boot your MacBook Pro using safe mode. First, shut down your MacBook Pro. Allow it to be for 20 seconds, then turn it back on. Press and hold the shift button while it's booting. Log into your Mac once the login window appears. Here are steps to boot your MacBook Pro with Apple Silicon in safe mode. First, shut down your MacBook Pro. Press and hold the power button until the load-in startup option appears. Select a volume, then press and hold the shift button. Click continue in safe mode. Once your MacBook Pro has been booted into safe mode, allow it to boot until the end. After that, restart your MacBook Pro. This will automatically remove your MacBook from safe mode and you can start using it normally. Method 4, use the keyboard sequence. So, maybe your MacBook Pro display is dead and stuck in the black screen of death and you're wondering how you're going to rectify it. It's quite easy. Your keyboards can do the fixing even if your screen is blind. Here are the steps to use for the keyboard sequence to revive your dead screen. First, press the power button once. Then press S, which is the shortcut button for sleep. Then press and hold the power button for 4 seconds to force a shutdown. Wait for 16 seconds before pressing the power button again to turn it on. Method 5. Force reboot your MacBook Pro. Now, if your MacBook Pro is black, it's recommended that you reboot it first of all to see if the display returns. But since your screen is black, there's only one way to reboot, force rebooting. And this method works for all versions of MacBook. Here are the steps to follow to force reboot your MacBook. 1. Tap and hold the Touch ID button until your MacBook Pro restarts. In cases where your MacBook doesn't have a Touch ID button, press and hold the power button to restart it. Another way is by pressing the Control plus Command plus power keys. Part 3, how to recover data from MacBook Pro black screen. And now the moment you've all been waiting for. Remember I mentioned at the beginning of this video that I'm going to teach you how to recover? Well, one thing you'll also need to understand is that trying to fix your MacBook black screen problem could potentially result in losing your data. So you want to make sure that your data is securely backed up, and there's no other perfect way to do this than using Recoverit. Also, you're going to need another MacBook Pro for this next process. Here are the steps to follow to securely back up your data using Wondershare Recoverit. Step 1, the first step is to launch the data recovery software on the new computer and choose Recover from Crash Computer under the last tab. Click Start to go on. Step 2, please insert a USB drive to create a bootable media drive. Once you connect it to your working computer, it will show in your drop-down box. Step 3, Recoverit starts creating the bootable media drive on Mac. During the process, do not remove the USB flash drive out of your Mac computer. Step 4, boot the troubled computer from the created bootable media. Step 5, once booted, Recoverit will allow you to select and recover the data you wish to save. So, if you follow these steps as I've just laid them out, you won't have to worry about your black screen anymore. Thanks for watching this video, and please don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel and make your contribution in the comment box below. See you next time.